With multiple files, our code will look more organized and easier to navigate. Make a new file called example.lua. Make sure it's in the same folder as main.lua. In this file, we put test equals 20. Now if you print test in main.lua, you will see the test is nil. This is because we haven't loaded the file yet. We can load the file with require by passing the file name in a string as argument. Do not add .lua, simply type example. Put this at the top of love.load. Now that we load the file, you can see that it prints 20. Test is what we call a global variable. You can use it everywhere in the project. The opposite of a global variable is a local variable. We make a local variable by writing local in front of the variable name. So if you write local in front of test, you will see that it prints nil again. Local variables are limited to their scope. In this case, the scope is the file, but if you put a variable in a function, then the function is the scope. Meaning that outside of the function, test is not the same variable as inside the function. To get a good understanding of this, we just need to try something out. I created multiple variables called test, each with their own value. When I print a game, you'll see that it prints 40, 30, 20, 10. The first test is a global variable I made in main.lua. The variable is available in all files. The second test is a local variable. The variable is only available in this file. It does not affect the global variable. The third test is the parameter of the function I created. It's only available in this function and does not affect the local variable of this file. The fourth test is a local variable inside an if statement inside the function. It's only available in this if statement and does not affect the function's parameter. So if we print this test, its value is 40. Then we print the parameter test, it's still 30, because the test inside the if statement was local to that if statement. Then we print the test outside of the function. It's still 20, as the parameter test is local to the function. And lastly, we print the test in main.lua, which is still 10, because the test inside rectangle.lua is local to that file. So that's how local variables work. Require returns whatever the file returns. So if we return the string test at the end and print require example, you will see it prints test. The returned value is stored, and if we require the file again, it will return the stored value. That's it for this tutorial. Now that we know how requiring files and local variables work, we can start exploring libraries. Thanks for watching.